Luke 23, Luke 39 to 43.
Luke 23:39 to 43. Le tsebe go bane go tlo ba le mehla yeo ba tlo gore ba le hlonolo ke ba opa le mala a sa ka wa belega le mabela a sa ko a musha ke mo ba tlo go bolela ba ira dithaba ba re re weleng ba ira mebuto ba re re khupetseng go bane ge setlhare sa moketla ba se dira ka mogwao se se omilego se tlo dirwa eng le ba bangwe ba babedi ba di senye ba iswa le yena gore ba yo bolawa ge ba fitlhile mo ba rego sorry ba ba go ba re ke legateng ba mmapola sefapanong ba bapolla le disenyi tseo se sengwe ba ka letsola letsogotlo le letona.
Let me read in English. I said Luke 23.
Luke 23.
And I say what?
39.
All right, let me read from 39 to 43.
One
of the criminals who had been hanged on a cross beside him kept hurling abuse at him, saying, Are you not the Christ? Save yourself and us from death. But the other one rebuked him, saying, Do you not even fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? We are suffering justly because we are getting what we deserve for what we have done. But this man has done nothing wrong. And he was saying, Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. And Jesus said to him, I assure you, and most solemnly say to you, today you'll be with me in paradise. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. I just want to share with you thoroughly, and I want you to understand the scriptures. Because when I was reading this, I began to understand that I gave people what will happen.
On Wednesday.
And I even said many leaders of
charis,
they will face a lot. And especially leaders of charis and some Christians. Because we are in a great year of a bigger assignment.
But
it's like that. Know that there's a relief that is coming from our God. So here we can see a suffering.
Just like
suffering. In fact, endure suffering. That's what I want to talk about. There's going to be a suffering, but for a short time. Tell you about there will be a suffering of a short time. So we read about these two men who were criminals who were at the cross with Jesus. You could see the first one insulting Jesus. But the one I want to talk about is this second one. Is the second one. The second one already proved to us that Jesus was innocent. But when he looked at himself, there was no hope except the same Jesus on the same cross. And the Bible says, he answered the one who was insulting. Can you see that we have got no way out except death.
We have no rasana tsela ya uchwa kan taliho.
And we have got this man who's innocent.
And munashu yena ana le ka mulatu.
And we know that this man is innocent.
And naria tsebo ri muthu ana mulatu.
This man might be a king.
Munthu wa ka ba ali sinotolo.
In my pains.
Mo botokong baka.
There is nobody around here who can save me.
Ga o fe mo akata ga mpulusha.
This man, when he's suffering, he began to say, it's better I endure until death. But by making friendship with the one on the cross, the Bible shows that they were in pains. They were groaning. That's why the first man insulted
that
Jesus.
That is why oh, I'm a tomaila arugana.
Because it is easy
to curse
God when you are in pain. But you know, if you understand that there is still hope towards death, you can still endure that pain. You can still endure that suffering. And believe that though you're a prisoner, there can still be another life ahead. In fact, today I want to speak with you briefly so that you understand that the suffering you go through, it will never kill you. Is just there because there is someone who rose from the dead. Tell somebody, say, my friend, the suffering you are going through, it will never kill you. It will rather sustain you. It will rather establish you. Listen, we know very well where you are standing. When you are suffering, is where you prove to us where you are standing. You can rather endure the pain until death. We need Christians who can say, even if I cannot see a blessing, but I want to make friendship with this man Jesus and endure pain until death. Because this pain of suffering won't kill me. The suffering has come so that I insult this man, so that I rebuke Jesus, or I stand against what I believe. Can I tell you, this suffering is there to test you. Tell your neighbor, suffering is there to test you, so that you speak who you are before God. Look at the promise of Jesus. When this man says,
Jesus,
I know why I'm suffering, but can you remember me when you reach there? You know what this man was saying? He was saying, remember me of what I did now on the cross. Even when I'm on the cross, I never insulted you. All along I was cursing you. But I've reached the cross. But I never insulted you. I've seen many people, when they face some challenges, when they face problems, they find a way out. And the way out which does not glorify God. We need to be Christians who can enjoy that suffering. I don't know if you are hearing me. The Bible says Jesus suffered and endured pain because of the glory that was set before him. Listen, suffering tells you that there is a glory. Tell my friend, suffering tells you that there is the glory. I don't know what you are going through, but I'm here to tell you that this suffering is there just to cover the glory. You must lift your eyes. You will see the glory that is coming before you. That's why the Bible says, arise and shine, because the glory is coming to you. If you believe, shout hallelujah. If you read 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 19 to
23,
we found favor when we suffer unjustly. There are times when you suffer not because you have done anything wrong, but you suffer when you are in the Lord. That's where favor comes. I don't know if you're hearing me. The favor will locate you when you are suffering unjustly. I don't know if you're hearing me. Look here. If you suffer because you have done something, that suffering is telling you to repent. But if you suffer whereas you have done nothing, there's a favor that is coming upon your life. Some people are sick here and they don't know why they're sick. Others have got leg here, they don't know why they've got that leg. But if you are holding the cross and you are holding Jesus, there's a favor that will come upon you. I don't know if you're hearing me. I feel like you are suffering, but it's about to come to an end. I'm here to tell you that the suffering will never tolerate you from today, because there's a power of God that is here that is about to locate your life and bring a change. And this change, everybody will see it. I don't know if you're hearing me. There's a change. Listen, you can find some people, few people knowing that you are suffering, and those people are there for your testimony. But can I tell you this? But when God honor you and take you out of suffering, you know what will happen? Everybody will know you out. Let me prophesy, someone is listening to me. You are about to be known that you are no longer suffering. I say you are about to be known that you are no longer suffering. Listen, that suffering was there to tell you that it was a first step to the grace and favor that is coming upon your life. There are some people who are listening to me that God wants to honor them today. I thank God for suffering. I thank God for suffering. I don't know if you're hearing me. You must thank God for your suffering, because that suffering is attracting God's attention. There's a God's attention that when God looks at you, the blessings will follow you. I don't know if you're hearing me. Allow the suffering to complete its work when you are rejoicing on what is coming. Don't look at suffering. Don't focus on what devil is doing. Focus on what God is about to do. It's favor. Listen, he who knows favor, he understands the promises of God, that they're yes and amen. He won't be shaken when the devil comes. He will stand his ground, because very soon he will testify. There is someone who's listening to me, and I want to tell you, the suffering of your family is over. The suffering in that family, it's over. And you are the one who will bring breakthrough in that family. I see you bringing breakthrough in the family. If you believe, say, I am the one. If you look at this verse, in 2 Timothy chapter 2, from verse 8 to 12, you know, here Paul was telling Timothy that I've been assigned for the gospel and I'm ready to suffer for it. I'm ready to suffer even for the chains. Listen to Paul. Paul said, I know there is suffering, but I can even go to jail because I'm holding the word of the Lord. Listen, there are some Christians that are here. They are holding the scriptures until to the end. And devil
And Satan is trying to put them in a prison of suffering. And try to make people who are opposers, they are like they are living better. But can I tell you here? You are about to overtake those people. I'm here to tell you that your suffering is over. I say your suffering is over. Listen, Paul said, Timothy. Timothy, I know Jesus Christ. And because I know Jesus Christ, I know I understand my suffering. It's because I'm preaching this. And I must preach things that I live. I must live my preaching. So don't worry about my suffering. It means Timothy was worried. And he said, Timothy, I'm ready even to be changed. For this gospel, I'm ready to believe in scriptures, even when other people are prospering in another way. I'm ready to hold the verse until God using that verse to bring a meaning. There are some Christians here you have been holding until now, but I'm here with the power of the Almighty to tell you your suffering is over. That sickness is over. That poverty is over. That opposition is over. God is about to confuse your enemies. Let them gather together. Just dance alone. Because you have got favor that is waiting for you. I see the grace of God is about to work in your life. Tell somebody, hey, I'm not afraid of suffering. I'm not afraid of suffering. I'm about to have a testimony. If you read Exodus 3 from verse 2 to 8, I love when God said to Moses, you know, that day it was a drama. It was a drama, I want to tell you. Can I tell you the drama? When God was looking in his people in Egypt, this was a drama. When Moses was behind the ship, when he was busy behind the ship, because Moses was a faithful man, his focus was on sheep. And God said, how can I send this man? I must remove his focus. I must take him back to what he didn't believe in. Remember, Moses was in Egypt and he was taken out of Egypt by running away. But now God was saying, Moses, I'm taking you back to Egypt. When you reach there, you must face the same man you have run away from. Face the same man and tell him, don't look at what you have done. You know what happened? There was a drama. The angel of the Lord descended and came to this tree, and the tree started to burn. And God wanted to speak with Moses. When Moses was talking, because he took his eyes out of the sheep and he looked on what the angel was doing. And listen to this. The Bible says, when he's about to look there, go and read. God said, oh, now he's looking. Let me speak with him. In other words, his eyes were taken from his enjoyment and taken back to where God is sending him, where he never thought he can go back there and face suffering and speak against that suffering. When he took off the eyes, when God said, hey, Moses, you have taken off You have seen me. Remove your shoes now. Remove your shoes. You must respect me. Take off your shoes. He took off the shoes. It shows that Moses was not respecting. When he took off the shoes, God said, listen, you have seen this, but I have come to send you. I have seen the suffering of my people. Even you are suffering, Moses. But you must preach a release to my people. Go back to Egypt and face that enemy. Go and face that enemy. Because the suffering of my people has reached my ears. So you, Moses, go back and face the one who's causing this suffering. And tell the people, allow my people to go. Allow my people to get out from this suffering. I'm here to tell you, I'm Moses today. I'm Moses today. I'm here to face Pharaoh. I've been sent there to face your Pharaoh. That where you are is not your place. Where you are, you are suffering. Listen, God is saying, I must not look on what I'm having. Even what I'm doing is suffering. I must take my eyes and go and approach Pharaoh. So today, I say Pharaoh. I say Pharaoh. Let the people go. The people of God are not supposed to suffer forever. The taskmasters, the taskmasters who were oppressing you, they are about to leave you. Those supervisors, those managers, I approach Pharaoh. I say, the spirit of Pharaoh, there is no more suffering that you will bring to our people. You spirit of Pharaoh, I command you, I command you, agree that you leave my people. I'm here with the mandate from our Father Jehovah to take you out from suffering. I can see you getting out of Goshen. I can see you going to a land of Canaan. Your suffering under these people, it's over. I say it's over. I say it's over. Where you are working, this suffering is over. Where you are doing business, your suffering is over. I don't know if you are hearing me. Shake somebody and say, hey, you spirit of Pharaoh, leave the people of God. Leave the people of God. Get out, you people of God. Egypt is not your place. Your suffering is about to come to an end today in the name of Jesus. Listen, you know what I'm telling you? It's a command from my Father. You have been suffering for a long time. When you get that money, you can't see what you are doing. And there's nothing that brings any source in your family. But today, when you are listening to me, I'm facing Pharaoh. I'm facing this Pharaoh. I say, hey, you're a king of the land. You are a king of the land, but you are not the king of my people. The king is Jehovah. I am here with a message. From today, you are taking what belongs to you. Your house has been waiting for you. Your car has been waiting for you. Your life has been waiting
fighting for you. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm here to tell you, because many of you, you were praying and you were fasting, and this day is the day you were fasting for. This is the day, if you are watching and you are suffering, this is the day you have been waiting for. That suffering is eradicated. That pain is leaving your body. That shame is about to be a history. There are some people who are listening to me. I want to tell you, your suffering is over. It's over. It's over. Shake somebody's head. Your suffering is over. If you read Romans 5, verse 1, you go to 4.
Why are we for?
The Bible says we have been justified by faith. That's why we had peace with God. So therefore, we are not surprised. We rejoice in tribulation. Why? Because our suffering brings endurance. We rejoice. That's the word the Bible says. We rejoice because we know where we come from. We rejoice. Listen to this. If you want to see results where there's no results, just rejoice. Rejoice. I found something. Sometimes devil will lower your spirit so that you must not see the plan of God upon your life. Just rejoice. What you are seeing is a shadow. It's about to pass. There's the grace of God that is about to be visible. Can I say this to you? There are some Christians this week who are about to smile because of their account in the bank. Why? Because our God is about to honor them. That suffering is eradicated. Your suffering is over. Shake someone and say, hey, what are you facing? What are you facing? What were you facing? Can you ask the person that question? The Bible said there's a peace. Because of this tribulation, we rejoice. Why? Because we are aware. We have got awareness. We understand the fellowship we have with God. That bring forth whatever that is happening around. But we rejoice because we know that there's something that is coming. So we can endure suffering. If you believe, say amen. From today, you must stop worrying about what you have. If you read Psalm 18, Psalm
18,
3-7, listen to this. Know what suffering is there for. Your suffering is there to make your enemy to laugh. I'm sure you're hearing me now. You are not suffering until your enemy laughs. Tell
them,
you are not suffering until your enemy
laughs
at you. And when you see your enemies laughing at you, know that God is responding. So here you can see that the suffering
turned
your enemy to see where, what you are facing. And from there, it becomes a story of the enemy. Because your enemy wants to discredit you. Your enemy wants to show you that you cannot rise. But I want to tell you, children of God, I can see you rising. On Wednesday, I was told by the Holy Spirit that this year you will make your parents proud. You will make your elders in the family proud. Listen,
they've been ridiculed because of you. People are laughing in your family. Laughing at your family. Because of what you're going through. This is the time that your enemy will faint when they see what God is doing in your life. This is the time you've been waiting for. They've been laughing, but they will never laugh again. They thought it's over with you. They didn't know that God was preparing the best. Can I prophesy someone who's listening to me? You're about to see your enemies asking forgiveness. They are coming. There are many. God will deal with them this week. Will deal with them this week. You must not worry about suffering. Let me speak with you. All people who are on top, they've been suffering. Even those who are educated, you have seen them on TV, wherever. Others, they read their books with lies that you cannot handle. I don't know if you're hearing me. There was suffering. Others were sent to school. Parents were trying to put things together. Everything was so difficult. I don't know if you're hearing me. But that is history. Now you have come to God. Now you have come to God. You are people of God. I say you are people of God. When you pray, God is about to honor you. Shame you went through is about to be covered. I say it's about to be covered. But at least today, you can believe Jesus. You have the Savior. You can command the suffering of your family to come to an end. Listen to this. Some people who are holding these papers. Because these papers, few people are having them. Can I tell you this? You can still suffer with these papers without Jesus. When you bring Jesus, He breaks the yoke of suffering. I don't know if you are hearing me. If you bring Jesus to your suffering, what you have experienced when you were young cannot come back again. I'm here to tell you, the suffering of the past will never come back to you. Your affliction will never rise up again. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Let me show you another scripture. Look at this one. In James 5, verse 31.
Jacob 5:13.
I look at this verse, it touched me. He said, if anyone among you, James 5:13.
Jacob 5:13.
If he's suffering, no other option except prayer. If anyone must not find other means of getting out of suffering except prayer. These scriptures sometimes we don't understand it. We try to save ourselves. Sometimes suffering tells us to pray. Listen to this. There are some families where people are suffering. And that suffering is not that you cannot do anything. God wants you to pray. He maybe wants to use you. Maybe
wants
to make you a blessing. I don't know if you're hearing me. A suffering, the instruction have been given. When you are facing it, just pray. Just pray. I have learned something. It's very difficult to pray when you are rich. It's very difficult to pray when you are rich. Because another phone, you have got five phones. When you are rich, you've got 4 or 5 phones. This one is putting a message, another one like that. It's so difficult. Look here, this phone, only one phone. It's keeping you busy. Look here, now when money comes, 4 or 5 phones. All of them, they are latest. They've got big things there. Big memory. It's not easy to pray. Listen to this. You can pray and make your lifestyle of prayer. You won't lose that prayer life when you are rich. I don't know if you're hearing me. Because listen, prayer is there to cancel suffering. It's only prayer that destroys suffering. If you read Matthew 24, verse 9 to 13, ask what are you facing? Ask your neighbor, what are you facing?
Which shamaki when I go panalichedife.
Before I conclude this, if you want to see there is suffering. Maybe let's talk about on the side of sickness. Your partner must be sick. When your partner is sick, you will see
something.
Especially when the wife is sick. You will see now. Maybe you've got small children. You begin to see the importance of your partner. And here, the child will be saying, I want food. And sometimes if the person is sick to extend that, it's about to die. Always when you sleep here, you wake up to look. You wake up to, it's happening. There are problems like that, it's happening. Life is not so easy. There's too much suffering.
Around.
I don't know if you're hearing me. Train yourself in prayer until God shows you things. You can overcome. Even when things like this understand, come, you will understand why you are facing all this. Let me show the scripture we read. Matthew 24. Read verse 9, Mama.
Verse 9. Mehleng yeo ba tlo le gafela tlaishong. Ba tlo le bolaya le tlo ba ba go hloiwa ke ditshaba jotlhe.
Read continuing.
Ke yena a tlo go pholoswa.
I want that verse again. Read it again, Mama.
Ye a tlo go tisha go fetla bofelong. Ke yena a tlo go pholoswa.
Listen to this. There's going to be a great tribulation.
O tlo ba le ditlaisho tse kgolo.
Suffering.
O tla isheya.
You are justified by tolerance.
Wena o tlo ba ya lokileng ka lebaka la go gotelela.
Your salvation will come when you are enduring. If you read that verse, you will see. Can you read it again? Read it in your Bible. Read it again in your Bible. You will see. It's what is happening now. It's what is happening now. Can you read that again, Mama, in your Bible? Matthew 24. It's what is happening now in our generation.
Verse 9.
Read from verse 9 there.
Batlo gafela ba bantsi tlaishegong batlo le bolaya le tloba ba o hloiwa ka ditshaba tshotlhe ka bakala le ena laka mehleng yo batlo gopta itloba ba bantsi batlo ekana batlo hloyana go tloba le ba profeta ba bantsi ba maka ba batlo fura ba bantsi go me ka go ata ha magopo go tlo nna tla le rato la ba bantsi ya tla go tishetsa go fetla bofelong.
But the one who endures and bears up under suffering to the end will be saved.
Amen.
Look here. This scripture is fulfilled today. you could see what devil is doing.
Wa bona dilo tse di rwang ke Satan.
And is about to do on Christians.
Ene di khofelo di ala ba pulosweng.
But when you endure,
mara ha o gotelela.
You are about to overcome.
O khofelo o hlola.
When you leave this house.
A o toela a toa ka ranto
ye. I'm expecting results.
Ke lebeletse mi putso fela.
I'm expecting results.
Ke lebeletse mi putso.
I'm reading this verse for the
who's in the Bible. Ke ba la verse ya ke mangana le.
Can read for us.
Ya tshwereng Bible ya ka re balelang.
Yeah, let's give someone mic here.
Mo khauso.
Read here to these people. Can read here. Read, I want you to listen again to that verse.
Then they will deliver you to tribulation and kill you. You will be hated by all nations for my name's sake. And then many will be offended, will betray one another, and will hate one another. Then many false prophets will rise up and deceive many. And because lawlessness will abound, the love of many will grow cold. But he who endures to the end shall be saved.
This is your verse.
Give us a line.
There is lawlessness.
Oh, now we'll talk about law.
But endure.
Mara hotelel.
There is betrayal.
Oh, now we are gone.
But endure.
Mara hotelel.
There is lack.
But
endure.
There
is sickness. But endure. Think about if the Bible says you'll be hated by the old people. It means no one will help you. But endure. Can I prophesy you? Your endurance is about to give the best results. If you believe, shout, say
amen.
There are some Christians who are listening to me. You can understand that Christianity is not fantasy. Because this must come to pass to Christians. Your endurance will take you to the results of your expectation. Suffering is very good. I've said it again, suffering. Because it takes you to where you stand. Listen to this. I have been looking at everything. Life of money is not good. But suffering. If you are suffering for God, and you are suffering for God, is then you will know that there is something in you that the devil is looking for. And I say to you, God is on your side. You won't lose it. I say you won't lose it. Can you receive the grace? Can you receive the grace? Can you receive the grace? This week, I'm talking about this week. What will happen this week? God will start to work for you. He will start to bless you. I don't know if you're hearing me. He will start to lift you. When people are saying it's over with you, it's over with you. You will see money coming to you. When people say you can't get a job, you will see yourself getting a job. When people say you will die with sickness, you'll be healthy, healthy. If you believe, say amen. I say your suffering is over. 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 I know this man who said, I can rather suffer with the people of God than to enjoy sin for little time. Little time, it means suffering is for a short time. You have been suffering. It was for a short time. Today, that spirit that was oppressing you, a spirit of Pharaoh, will leave you today.